Aloha! What's up, fam? Hope you guys are doing well today. So you booked a Royal Caribbean cruise and you're ready for the next step. It's almost time to check in. Here's a couple tips to help you guys with that process along the way. Ohana, Ohana, living in the sea with you.
Ohana, Ohana, yeah. Ohana, Ohana, living in the sea with you. Ohana.
Thanks for stopping in today, guys. Congratulations on booking your next Royal Caribbean cruise. And if you've already booked your airfare, you've got your hotel arrangements all set for the night before or when you're coming back home, the next thing you're gonna wanna start doing if you've already looked at excursions is you're gonna start wanting to think about check-in. So I know it seems like it's not really that important, but on Royal Caribbean it is, and the reason for that is because of your boarding time. You've gotta wait until 90 days before your boarding day in order to start the check-in process. Now you can't start earlier than that, Royal Caribbean won't let you, but you wanna make sure that on that 90th day you're ready to go, and the reason for that is, like I said before, boarding time. Now your boarding time selection in the day of embarkation is gonna be determined by what you pick. And the first time slots, usually the 10:30 to 11 a.m. and the 11 to 11:30 a.m., they go the quickest. So if you wanna make sure that you're able to board as early as possible on that first day and make the most out of the first day of your cruise, you're gonna wanna make sure that you get that early embarkation time, which can only be done by logging into Royal Caribbean's website 90 days before your sailing date. You can go on the website or you can go to the app. I suggest using the app. It seems to work better for everything I've done. So a little good news is you don't actually have to complete the entire check-in process 90 days before. You don't have to actually scan your passport and do all that, but you do definitely want to make sure you go in and select your boarding time. Because if you don't select a boarding time at 90 days, chances are you're gonna be stuck with something like a 1 to 1:30 or maybe a 2 to 2:30 time slot, which would be one of the last embarkation times to board the ship. So is it competitive? Yes, actually. Usually, a lot of people try and wait until midnight on the 90-day mark in order to try and get the best time spot possible for their sailing. But from what I've noticed is that if you're able to log on the next day, usually in the morning, you can still get that 10:30 a.m. time slot. So you don't have to be up at midnight refreshing, refreshing, refreshing. Because in my experience, when I've done that, I actually end up refreshing for 5 or 10 minutes. It doesn't work. And then after everyone sort of stops trying to refresh it, after about 20 or 30 minutes, that's when they'll actually allow you to check in. After you've selected your check-in time, if you want to finish the check-in process, all you're going to have to do is go through, answer those security questions, as well as add a debit card, add a picture of your passport, and all that good stuff. Once you're done with that, you have to wait till 24 hours before, and you'll be able to then answer your health questionnaire, which is usually things like, how are you feeling? Do you have a fever? Just to make sure you're not getting on the ship with any underlying COVID symptoms. Thank you, Royal Caribbean, for doing your part to protect us. We appreciate it. Before I go, just want to share with you a couple more topics that you might want to look into as you start getting ready for your cruise. The first one is going to be Royal Up, which is Royal Caribbean's silent auction upgrade for a better room. So if you're in an interior, I always, always, always do the Royal Up. I put in whatever amount I feel comfortable in order to try and bid and win, hopefully, an upgraded room. So if you guys are curious on more information about the Royal Up process, you guys will see the video pop up there in a second after this video is done. But one more thing before I go, there's also another video that's gonna be coming out soon. It's gonna be about Facebook groups. So if you guys did not know, Royal Caribbean always has Facebook groups for each of their sailings. So I actually created one for my sailing in December. I'm really excited for that. There's already 250, 300 members in that group. So it took about 6 months, 7 months to get there, but there wasn't already one for my sailing, so I decided to make one. And it's been a fun process getting to know everyone involved. And the reason why I would suggest joining a Facebook group is because if you join the Facebook group, you'll get valuable information. Like, for example, I didn't know they were gonna allow us to book our entertainment on board before we were actually on board. So usually you have to wait until you're on the ship, connected to the ship's Wi-Fi, but luckily for me, on my next Oasis of the Seas sailing, I was able to book all of my entertainment options already. So I don't have to worry about jumping on the ship and logging into the Wi-Fi and making reservations. I already got that all taken care of, and I wouldn't have even known that it was possible to have been done if it wasn't for someone from the Facebook group. All right, so those are just a few things that can often get overlooked during the cruise booking process. I hope you guys enjoy everything that this video had to offer. And much love, mahalo nui, and aloha.